Self-driving cars are not a futuristic concept, they are a new reality. They promise the idea of safe transportation, a solution to traffic congestion and the absence of reckless drivers on the road. However, it sounds better than it actually is. We will discuss the challenges of implementing this technology, recent developments and why we might have to wait. In the end, we'll show accidents involving self-driving cars when the autopilot turned out to be less intelligent than a human. The idea of creating autonomous vehicles without human drivers has been around for a while. Experiments with radio-controlled cars were actively conducted in various countries as early as the 1930s. Francis Goodwin is considered a pioneer in this field for building and demonstrating several radio-controlled cars. In the 1930s, experiments were also carried out with radio-controlled military equipment in different countries. Even in the USSR, two teletanks battalions were created, although their effectiveness in real combat situations was questionable. However, the concept of autonomous vehicles gained new momentum with the advent of microelectronics. The first car equipped with an onboard computer and a semblance of autopilot was the Firebird II, introduced by General Motors back in 1956. This car was considered a true embodiment of the future. It had a titanium body, two gas turbine engines capable of reaching speeds of up to 300 km per hour, not to mention a television set in the cabin. Nowadays, technology has come a long way thanks to neural networks and machine learning, making it possible for cars to move autonomously. In Moscow, for example, you can even get a Yandex robot taxi through a regular app. A similar feature exists with Uber, whose cars roamed New York City until they were involved in a fatal accident. However, it's important to clarify that these cars only operate on specific routes and there is an operator sitting in the passenger seat to monitor the process. The fact that the future has already practically arrived is truly exciting, as it's one thing to have lane-keeping assistance as an option in modern cars and another to have full-fledged autonomous movement without the need to sit behind the wheel. How this works and the important nuances will be discussed further. All the cars we drive in one way or another are already part of the vehicle autonomy evaluation system. However, they usually receive a zero rating, meaning they have no automation, while the fifth level assumes that the computer takes over driving and decision-making. In reality, such vehicles are hardly found on public roads. They mostly exist as concept cars without a steering wheel, which we'll discuss shortly. It's important to understand what the autopilot does in general. The whole process consists of four real-time stages. Localization. This process involves precisely determining the location of the self-driving vehicle with ultra-high precision, within a few centimeters. It is achieved through data collected from sensors and high-precision maps containing extensive information such as lane markings, traffic lights and road signs. Even in the absence of visibility due to weather conditions, this doesn't pose a problem for self-driving vehicles. Perception. Identifying the objects in the surroundings. Self-driving vehicles recognize them, determine their speed and direction of movement using cameras and lidars. This category includes all the variables on the road, from pedestrians to taxi drivers who change lanes actively. As mentioned earlier, the car's vision in the form of cameras and lidars is responsible for this stage. Prediction. The crucial stage in which the self-driving vehicle tries to predict the movements of other road users. Neural networks primarily play a significant role here, as they've learned to anticipate human drivers' actions based on extensive datasets. During training, the vehicles are loaded with statistics on accidents, detailed cases recorded on surveillance cameras, and all this helps the car better understand human drivers. Planning. This is the final stage in which, based on the data collected, the algorithms of the self-driving vehicle predict their future actions and send commands to the control systems, such as accelerating or braking and steering. These stages should take only milliseconds, just like with a human driver. As you can understand, there are two main components of a self-driving car – its vision and the software that processes the collected information. Practically every company, from Yandex and Uber to Ford and General Motors, uses LiDAR for data collection, and some even acquire startups or produce their own LiDAR systems. But LiDAR has a significant downside. It can't distinguish colors, can't classify complex-shaped objects, and can't recognize images on signs if the data is not already in the loaded map. Consequently, a car simply cannot navigate adequately in unfamiliar territory. Add weather conditions, tree branches, or eyes on signs into the equation, and even a well-known route can challenge LiDAR. Moreover, when the device sees an object on the road, it can easily misinterpret it as a boulder in its shape, abruptly turning the steering wheel or performing an emergency stop. Most importantly, LiDAR is the costliest component of any self-driving car. Prices range from $10,000 to hundreds of thousands for advanced sensors, even without the problems mentioned above. It's evident that such technology cannot be mass-produced because it requires a mass replacement of conventional vehicles to make all traffic on the roads predictable. Hence, Tesla has completely abandoned the use of LiDAR. Elon Musk has been categorical about this technology. His company is fundamentally refusing to use LiDAR in its autopilot systems. This decision is justified by the fact that such systems are considered too bulky and costly. Tesla believes that with data obtained from 8 cameras, they can easily determine distances to other vehicles and obstacles, provided their neural networks are correctly trained. But LiDAR is not the only stumbling block. We will discuss other nuances that prevent self-driving cars from advancing further. Of course, there are numerous advantages, such as transporting goods in highly dangerous areas during natural disasters or military actions, effectively eliminating risks to human lives. For civilian use, there are plenty of benefits too. Logistics improves, there's no need to pay driver salaries, and fuel consumption is optimized. Humanity gains millions of working hours that are no longer wasted sitting in traffic jams, and the risk of accidents due to human error is reduced. Moreover, vehicles become accessible to people with physical disabilities. It sounds magical, right? And it seems like the technology is already there. But what about the downsides? So far, there is no regulatory framework for classifying such vehicles, and it's unclear who is responsible in case of damage. There have already been precedents where the autopilot incorrectly processed information and caused accidents, some even fatal. This also extends to the overall reliability of the software. It needs to be a program that never fails, because any lag or glitch could cost lives. Not to mention the loss of jobs and the ability to handle unpredictable critical situations that are impossible to predict as long as conventional cars are on the roads. There's a reason why driving schools teach that the main danger on the roads is another driver. Inadequate reactions or maneuvers are simply impossible to plan for. So it turns out everything in self-driving cars is great, but only when every car communicates with a common system that builds and controls routes without human interference. However, the most promising fields where autonomous technology is already in use include freight transportation and courier delivery. Tesla unveiled its self-driving truck, the Tesla Semi, 6 years ago, with ambitious plans to start mass production by 2019. However, at present, production is on hold until Tesla can independently manufacture batteries for its vehicles, despite a large number of pre-orders placed by approximately 800 companies worldwide. Although many consider Tesla as pioneers in autonomous cargo vehicles, it's not entirely accurate. The first technology was presented by Mercedes-Benz with its future truck. This truck is equipped with a camera system capable of recognizing road markings, single and dual lanes, stationary and moving objects, as well as pedestrians. It can interact with other vehicles on the road and even receive information about traffic jams and roadworks in advance. However, autonomous trucks are already on public roads. In the United States, TuSimple's long-haul autonomous truck operates under the supervision of a driver, but is already delivering goods between Phoenix and Dallas, covering a distance of 900 miles. Robot couriers also fulfill their functions in real life, used by Amazon and Yandex for commercial food and order deliveries. Granted, their operational areas are limited, but in major cities, you can already encounter a robot standing alongside you at a pedestrian crossing. Here is a unique application of self-driving vehicles from the startup BaseTrack. Their innovative technology relies on collected geospatial data provided by telematic devices. These data are used to create a virtual path that the vehicle automatically follows, essentially forming an autopilot train with a predetermined route. The self-driving car analyzes its location, matching it with the coordinates of the virtual route, and makes decisions about further movement. For additional accuracy, the system is equipped with stereo cameras capable of measuring distances to objects and, if necessary, radars. Importantly, costly LiDARs are not used. This technology is accurate enough to provide navigation within an inch of accuracy, regardless of weather conditions. However, the downside is that this system cannot interact with moving objects like pedestrians and other vehicles. This technology can be successfully utilized in closed areas and specialized test tracks where onlookers and other road users are absent. Currently, it is actively deployed in the mining industry, where transport follows a strictly defined route and doesn't venture onto public roads. Civilian projects are also advancing rapidly. For instance, the British company Origo introduced its self-driving bus auto shuttle as part of the development of autonomous public transportation in Europe. Initially, autonomous shuttles will have a human operator on board, ready to intervene in case of errors. However, Origo plans to remove the human from the cabin in the future and replace them with a remote operator, who is not physically present on the bus but capable of taking control in critical situations. The company is also considering the possibility of training passengers to use the driverless bus, while simultaneously developing fully autonomous technology. Top automotive manufacturers are also keeping pace by offering functional prototypes of vehicles without traditional driver positions. Audi A-Icon. The self-driving car represents a remarkable feat of technology. You won't find a traditional steering wheel, pedals, or even basic safety airbags in its standard configuration. All of this is because the vehicle is controlled by artificial intelligence with a focus on preventing all accident situations. The car doesn't boast impressive acceleration figures. The electric vehicle can reach speeds of up to 80 miles per hour. However, a single battery charge can cover 550 miles. In essence, this is a conventional civilian transportation vehicle that could easily populate city streets, offering a comfortable point-to-point transportation. If you're looking for a touch of luxury, there's another option for you. Rolls-Royce 103EX. This stylish self-driving car is entirely autonomous in motion. The absence of a steering wheel and pedals is compensated by an innovative virtual control system and the onboard computer communications with the driver using a refined female voice. Rolls-Royce offers a mobile roof that automatically closes once passengers have taken their seats. The wheels are concealed in special compartments, creating the illusion of floating in the air while in motion. It's an exceptional blend of comfort and elegance and, most importantly, luxury in an innovative form. Mercedes-Benz F015. The Mercedes-Benz Group also didn't stay on the sidelines and in early 2015 introduced a unique car embodying cutting-edge future technologies. The vehicle's appearance is remarkably original, with a minimum of standard classical features and a maximum of innovative concepts. The screens take center stage, and the car relays information about everything happening outside the cabin, carefully scanning the route and discreetly warning about possible maneuvers while interacting with passengers. It all looks beautiful and fantastic, but we'll have to wait until such vehicles fill public roads. Ordinary people often dream of self-driving cars where all they need to do is press a few buttons in a mobile app, then comfortably settle into the cabin and, for example, work on a laptop or enjoy watching movies, while artificial intelligence confidently takes them to their destination. This vision of the future will undoubtedly come to pass, but at the moment, cars are still not ready for this scenario. Cars without a steering wheel, pedals, and fully autonomous ones only exist as conceptual projects, as demonstrated earlier. For self-driving cars to be widely used, it's necessary not only to develop the appropriate regulations and reduce costs, but also to ensure the technological readiness of cities. For example, autopilots face challenges in bad weather, when road signs and markings are not visible. Therefore, it will take a few more years before these issues are resolved. There's also more for self-driving vehicles to learn. For instance, modern autonomous cars don't handle poorly maintained roads very well, and such roads are prevalent all over the world, especially if you venture away from the main road. In other words, if a pothole is on the map, the self-driving car will avoid it. But if it's not on the map, who knows? Not to mention temporary obstacles like road work when the signs are forgotten. Companies are focused on collecting the maximum amount of data, but they haven't delved into the nuances yet. We might see a car that can take a curious onlooker on a pre-mapped route, but a car that fully caters to all the needs of an ordinary person simply doesn't exist yet. After every test drive, a self-driving vehicle accumulates hundreds of gigabytes of data for later analysis, recordings from cameras, sensor readings. But again, these are data from a specific trip along a specific route, while there are billions of variables on the same road. Accidents involving autopilot serve as confirmation of this fact. In mid-March 2018, an autonomous taxi from Uber gained significant attention due to an accident that occurred in Tempe, USA. The vehicle was operating in autonomous mode, reaching a speed of 45 miles per hour. On a dark and poorly lit road, a 49-year-old cyclist suddenly appeared. However, the autonomous driving system made a mistake by misidentifying the woman as a minor obstacle. The human operator inside the vehicle was distracted and relying solely on the automation system. As a result of the accident, The woman sustained serious injuries and passed away. This case became the first documented instance of a person losing their life in a collision with an autonomously controlled vehicle. Another fatal incident occurred on Highway 101 in California. To maintain distance from the vehicle in front, a Tesla Model X crossover reduced its speed in advance. 4 seconds before the collision, the lane was cleared and the electric car sharply accelerated. Traveling at 90 miles per hour, the car lost control and crashed into a concrete barrier. The software didn't react to the skid. Immediately after the collision, the car caught fire and exploded, resulting in the tragic death of the 38-year-old engineer from Apple, Walter Huang. Another electric vehicle from Tesla was involved in an accident in Greece, marking the first incident of its kind outside of North America. Yuzu, a California resident, embarked on an extended journey in his new Tesla Model 3. Over 6 months, he traveled through 25 countries, covering more than 26,000 miles. The journey concluded on May 25th in Greece, when his sedan, traveling at a speed of 75 miles per hour, suddenly and unexpectedly made a right turn, colliding with a concrete barrier. It's important to note that the road was dry, clear, and well lit at the time of the accident, with no extreme weather conditions. Interestingly, despite none of the safety airbags deploying, the electric vehicle's driver was unharmed. He managed to regain control of the car but couldn't steer it away from the collision. Later, the car owner admitted to activating the autopilot and being distracted by using his smartphone, holding the steering wheel with just one hand. Tesla representatives swiftly responded to this incident, stating that the accident occurred in an area that was not yet supported, as Model 3 was not designed for use outside the United States and Canada at the time. Yet another peculiar case involved a Tesla Model S that collided with a fire department vehicle. The incident took place in South Jordan, Utah. The autonomous driving system failed to detect the bright red fire truck stopped at a traffic light. According to eyewitnesses, Tesla didn't even attempt to stop before hitting the emergency vehicle, as if it didn't perceive the obstacle. It was later revealed that 3.5 seconds before the collision, the car actually accelerated from 55 to 60 miles per hour. The future will certainly arrive, but it requires a little patience. Creating a self-driving car is only half the task. It's much more challenging to teach it to interact with other road users and anticipate their maneuvers. Thank you for watching.